Welcome to the Kiln Maintenance video series from Paragon Industries, maker of better designed kilns.
The tools needed for this repair include a quarter-inch nut driver, a case tightener, and a sanding block. As usual, the first thing we do before we work on a kiln is disconnect it from the power. Once this is done, please place the case tightener around the kiln and tighten it up. This allows the use of the quarter-inch nut driver to remove the screws easily. Once the screws are removed, go ahead and loosen the case tightener slightly to allow the brick to be removed from the kiln. To remove the brick, begin moving it around left to right until it is loose enough to be able to be pulled out without damaging the other bricks adjacent to it. When placing the new brick, there is a up and a down on the brick. You can look at the element grooves, and the deeper element grooves needs to be on the bottom of the brick. When placing the new brick back into the kiln, again, be sure not to damage the adjacent bricks. Most of the bricks are going to come and they're going to be larger than the brick that was removed. Use a sanding block to shape and size the brick to be placed back in the kiln properly. Again, care should be taken not to damage the adjacent bricks. Once the new brick is slid into place, we are going to go ahead and make sure that all the bricks adjacent to it are shaped back into the correct form. Once this is done, the case tightener can be used to tighten up the case again to place the screws back into the metal case. Once all of the screws are placed back into the case tightener will be removed. Once the case tightener is removed, some sanding may be required on the height of the brick as it's replaced. To do this, just feel the edges between the two bricks and use the sanding block to remove the amount of brick that's needed to make it a smooth and even surface. ¶¶